In this example, we are given that a rubber ball of mass m and radius r is submerged in water to a depth h. And on releasing the ball, we are required to find to what height above the water surface ball will jump. And we are given that we can neglect the resistance of water and density of water is rho w. In this situation, if we just draw a physical situation, you can say this is the water level. And from a depth h, a rubber ball is released. Then obviously when it will reach the surface, it will gain some kinetic energy. And further say it is raised up to a height h1 till its final velocity becomes 0. Now from the initial point to the final point, we can see its initial kinetic energy was 0 and final kinetic energy was also 0. So we can directly apply the work energy theorem from initial state to the final state. As it is going up, we can state when it is inside water, it was acted upon by the buoyant force. And the value of buoyant force can be simply written as 4 by 3 pi r cube, which is the volume of ball multiplied by density of water into g, v rho g. So, in this situation, we can directly use from points I to F, using work energy theorem, we get here initial kinetic energy of the ball was 0. When it is raised from a starting to final point, the work done by buoyant force on it can be written as Fb multiplied by H, as buoyant force is constant. So up to H only it is acting, outside no buoyant force is there. And another force acting on the ball from a starting to final point is the gravity. So it can be written as minus mg, total height is h plus h1, which can be taken as 0. So in this situation, if we just reanalyze it, the value of h1, the height up to which the ball can be raised, is given by buoyant force minus mg divided by mg multiplied by h. This is the expression we use. Buoyant force value we can easily substitute here. So the total height can be calculated as 4 by 3 pi r cube rho w. G can be cancelled, minus m upon m whole multiplied by h. This will be the answer to this problem.